Om Shri Sai Ram, offering my most humble salutations at the divine lotus feet of my beloved master, Bhagwan Shri Satya Sai Baba. Bhagavata Vahini, Chapter 39, The Omniscient as Student. Summary. Here Sage Shuka describes the time when Krishna and Balarama were sent to avail of formal education from the learned sage Sandipani in Kashi at the behest of Garga. Krishna and Balarama were ideal students, attentive, highly respectful, caring, and above all brilliant. They mastered the Vedas and 64 arts and sciences in just 64 days. When inquiring about the cause of underlying sadness in their guru's eyes, Sage Sandipani revealed that his only son had drowned in Prabhasa a while ago. Krishna and Balarama promised to help him recover the son and left for the place. They challenged the ocean first to return the son, who directed them to the ogre Panchajana, who had swallowed him. Krishna caught and killed the ogre in a fierce fight and acquired the conch Panchajanya, but the child was already with the god of death. So they marched up to his door, and even the god of death had to acquiesce to Krishna and return the son to him, and eventually back to the grateful sage Sandipani. Key takeaways. God, even in human avatar, has no need for any formal education. But despite that, Krishna chooses to go through the rigors of a conventional education, largely to demonstrate to the world the way that knowledge and guru are to be honored with veneration and humility, and to set an example for the generations to come. Let us similarly respect all the knowledge and education that we are receiving through His grace, and honor the individual teachers and gurus who are physical representatives of the guru principle, which is essentially God. Gratitude towards the gift of knowledge from the guru, highlighted by the principle of Guru Dakshina, is held in highest esteem. Krishna's persistence in chasing up his commitment to fulfill his promise to his guru by even leading right up to the death's door is meant to be an example to humanity to honor and fulfill all the knowledge and talents that we have been bestowed with to the best of our ability as expressions of gratitude to God for providing them to us. In reality, for the avatar, all human relations picked by him for the human roles, father, mother, teacher, wife, son, etc., are all in effect devotees and sacred souls that he wants to bless and grant bliss to as appropriate to their merits and needs. So it cannot be understood fully by human eyes. Similarly, in the drama of life, let us also fulfill our respective roles to the best of our ability, but at the same time, not take ourselves and our relative relationships too seriously, as in actually everything is finally only in the hands of our divine dictator. End of chapter 39. Jai Sai Ram.